midst of it all. Fixing my eyes on the prize. Fixing my eyes on the prize. On what really matters. On what really fixing my eyes on the prize. love cannot be conquered. Your love cannot be shaken. Your love cannot be conquered. Your love cannot be shaken. Oh, love. The greatest is love. Without your love, I am nothing. Oh, without your love, I gain nothing at all. Without your love, I am nothing. Without your love, I gain nothing at all. Without your love, I am nothing. Without your love, I gain nothing at all. Without your love, I am nothing, nothing. Without your to the light. Your love. Was the joy set before you that you would have my heart forever? And this was the joy set before you that you would have my heart forever. cannot quench, love floods cannot drown it. Love is strong as death, as jealous as the grave. Waters cannot quench, love floods cannot drown it. Love is strong as death, as jealous as the grave. The simple, profound message to pierce my heart. I want this simple, profound message to pierce my heart. There's nothing deeper, nothing more profound than your love. There's nothing more important in life than for me to know this love, than for me to get this love, than for me to live in this love. Oh, to know your love. I'll spend my life learning. I'll spend my life learning what it means. I'll spend each day. I'll spend each day searching the depths of your love. Sound. Hold me in your hand. Oh. Singing it loudest when you feel it least is when he's singing it loudest, so you hear, so you know that he truly loves you, so you you don't forget, so you don't forget that you are not forgotten. You are not forgotten, so you don't forget that you are not forgotten. You are not forgotten. You are seen and you are loved whole. You are not forgotten. He wants you to know. He wants you to know. You the same, 'cause he loves you the same. Oh, he loves you the same. Thank you.
something amazing to make you love us more. And we thank you for your love. As your children, we thank you for your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this time, we're going to transition into a time of worship in the Word of God. Today's passage comes from Revelation 21, verses 1 through 8. We'll break it down into sections, and I'll read and we'll meditate together, and we can pray through it, and as the Holy Spirit leads, we will sing and pray through these verses together. If you would open up to Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 8. Verse 1, "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, 'Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God.'" Father, we thank you for this image of the future, of what it will be like, so that we can set our hope on things eternal, of a day when everything that's old will pass away, everything that's temporary will pass away, and there will be a perfect communion with our Father, with God himself. And there will be nothing to separate us from you. And that even now, that as we live on this earth, God, we're living by faith, choosing to see what is ahead, choosing to put all of our focus, all of our lives on the future, on what is not seen. That even everything that we're experiencing, it's all in preparation to be together with you. We're being prepared as a bride, a holy, beautifully dressed, prepared by God himself as the bride of Christ, as the church. That every time we choose to love you, we choose to sing to you, we choose to look to you and not to this world, that you're preparing us to be with our bride, to be with our groom. That it has eternal purpose, eternal meaning, that the sufferings that we experience now, the persecution, it all has meaning, and we're being prepared. And so we look to the future, not on what is now, but what lies ahead, God, to the day that we will be with God himself.
Taste it here on earth before that day.
the bride.
every fear with expectation, with hope for the dwelling of God in us with us. You're perfecting us in your love. You're perfecting us in your love.
Verse 4, He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. He who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. Then he said, Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. Father, not one tear or one moment of sadness that we experience goes unnoticed. And it's your desire to draw us close. You're so compassionate and understanding of the things that we go through, God. And here it says, I am making everything new. And we believe that even now, Father, as you're preparing us, you're making all things new. You're making us new in Christ. And we thank you, Lord, that we can hope in you. We can hope in your words. These words are trustworthy and true. That, Father, that you care for each thing that we go through, God. And you're faithful to comfort every time. You're faithful to draw us close. You never get tired, Father, of speaking your truth over us, of loving us. Yeah. And we're so thankful, Lord. We're so thankful that your words are trustworthy and true.
Unnoticed, and no tear goes forgotten, and no tear goes unnoticed, and no tear goes forgotten. All matters to you. It all matters to you. Every detail, every bit of suffering, it all matters to you. It all matters to you. Victorious day.
6. He who was seated on the throne said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. Those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. But the cowardly, the unbelieving, the vile, the murderers, the sexually immoral, those who practice magic arts, the idolaters, and all liars, they will be consigned to the fiery lake of burning sulfur. This is the second death." Father, we hear your words that one day you will say, "It is done." That he who is the Alpha and the Omega, who was at the beginning of time and will be there at the end, that Father, you will accomplish all things according to your will, that nothing will keep your plan from coming to pass. And Father, we pray, Lord, that we will be found faithful in every way, that, Father, that we will be counted among those who loved you to the very end, among those who are victorious, among those that you say will inherit all this, and that you will be our God, that we will be your children. And, Father, we want to know what this looks like even now, what it's like to follow your will each and every day of our lives, to be called your children in a broken world that does not know you. Father, that you would fill us with your Spirit so that we can hunger and thirst for your will, Lord. That above all else, we would thirst for your water, for living water, for the only thing that can satisfy us. We come to you, Lord, hungry and thirsty, looking to the day where all things will be perfected. Lord, and even as we are here, we choose not to focus on the things of this world. We don't choose to dwell on the things that the world chooses to idolize, God. But we know, Lord, that none of those things can ever satisfy us. But we choose to drink from the living water every day. We come to you, Lord, just wanting your presence, wanting to be with you, God. In this place as your sons.
To trust what you say, that you're good and your love is great. I'm broken inside, I give you my life. I need you soften my heart and break me apart. I need you to open my eyes to see that you're shaping my life. All I am, I serve. I flesh may fail, my God, you never will. I may be weak, your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, my God, you never will.
You're making all things new.
I may be weak, your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, my God, you never will. And I may be weak, but your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, my God, you never will. I may be weak, but your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, my God, you never will. Oh, you never fail. Give me faith to trust what you say. You're good, and your love is great. I'm broken inside, I give you my life. 'Cause I may be weak, your spirit's strong in me. My flesh may fail, but my God, you never will. I know I'm weak, but your spirit's strong in me. And my flesh will fail, but my God, you never will.
Yes, Lord, you are the Alpha and the Omega, and we are weak, and our flesh is passing away, but Father, you are making us new to dwell eternally with you, where you will be with us forever. And so we look to you, God, and to your trustworthy promises, and we remain in that place of faith and belief, unshaking, that even though we are perishing, Lord, our flesh is perishing, that one day we will dwell forever with you, God. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this time, we will transition to a time of intercession, and today we are interceding for the nation of Korea. So if you would like to follow along with the prayer points that will be shown on the slides, you can put your faith along with mine, and we can pray together for God's hand upon this nation. And specifically, we will be praying for the Word of God to really build up the churches and believers all across this nation, and that churches everywhere would be founded and firm in his word, and trusting in every word of God to build their life and their faith. Father, your word is the source of revival for the soul, and that when we meditate on it, God, on every word from the mouth of God, that our soul will be revived, and that all sorrow and disappointment, Father, will dissipate and will be made small. We will be renewed from the inside out, not a temporary encouragement that we find in the world, but when we meditate on your word, God, and trust in your promises, that from deep within, our soul is revived and we are steadfast in you, God. And we pray, Father, that as believers in churches meditate on the Word of God, and they hold fast to your truth, that every lie of the enemy will be extinguished, God, and that they will hold fast to the Word and resist the enemy. And we take authority over all the works of the enemy, every lie that has been sown into the hearts of believers. We take authority over it, and we declare that they are powerless, because the truth of God is more powerful than the lies of the enemy, and that Christ is sufficient. We hold on to the truth that Christ is sufficient for every sin, for every need, for every trouble that we face in our lives, God. And we cling to your word, Lord. And as we cling, God, that each one of us will be strong in our hope, no matter what we face, no matter what suffering that we are experiencing here in this life, God. Your words are spirit and they are life, Lord. They are spirit and life to us, God. They are medicine to our soul and health to all our body, Lord, no matter the circumstance. Let's pray. Father, your word is the source of wisdom for everyone who believes in it, for everyone who trusts in it. And Father, we don't care to be wise in the ways of this world. But God, as we humble ourselves to the word of God, which is perfect, we know that we are being made wise. Not wise in our own right, but simply because we trust God for what he says, and that we put our hope in it, and we trust in every word that you say. So we speak your word over our situation, God. We speak your word, Father, because it brings wisdom to us, God. And we pray, Lord, that as each church, as each local church is being filled with your word, God, that your pure wisdom that's from above, that's loving and humble, it does not exalt itself, Lord, but it's pure wisdom from God, that as we preach this word of God, that it will go out across this land with power and authority and with simplicity in the gospel to convict hearts, God, that this is the wisdom of God. It's simple, but it's convicting and it's true, Lord. And we pray that as it is preached, God, everywhere across this nation, Lord, that it will bring conviction and power, Lord. Let's pray. Says that the precepts of the Lord are right and they bring rejoicing to the heart. They are to be more desired than any gold, sweeter also than honey. Father, we find joy in our hearts, pure joy that does not fail us when we put our lives, build our lives upon the Word of God. Father, your Word teaches us that you're the one rejoices over us with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. He will exult over you with loud singing. And Father, we read this word and it produces pure joy inside of us, God, because we know that we can't earn your love. You just give it to us. And it's a joy that does not fade away. It's a joy that we cannot get from this world, God, because everything else in this world will pass. But your word does not pass, and your love for us does not fail. And so we pray, God, for a growing desire and a fervent love for your word in this nation, God, to be upon all of your churches and upon the heart of every believer. And we pray, Lord, that your truth, that God's truth, would bear fruit of pure joy in the lives of believers. And we pray that this joy will permeate every believer's sphere of influence, God, and that where those churches are, that this pure joy would permeate their communities, God, so that wherever there is darkness, the darkness will flee. We thank you for this. this pure joy in your word, God, which does not fail. And it comes from delighting in your word, God, delighting in the joy that comes from your perfect word, God. Let's pray. Father, your word is a source of clarity and light. Your word says that the commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The entrance of your word gives light. Father, that everywhere your word goes, it brings clarity and light. And we pray, Father, for this nation, that as your word goes out every time, God, that blind eyes would be opened and hearts would be turned to the Lord, that your light would shine, God. And that unbelievers would be just turned to this light because it is so pure and it's so true and it's so contradictory to everything that's inside of them or everything that they've seen. God, your word is pure and it brings light. And even as you use human lips, Father, this wisdom that we preach is not from us. These words are not our own, but they are yours. And we pray that as your word goes out, that your spirit, Father, would bring this light to the hearts of the people. And we pray, Father, that when your truth goes out, God, it does not come back unaccomplishing of what it was sent out to do, but it reaches even to the darkest places of our society, of our lives, the most broken places of who we are, God. And it does not come back to you without accomplishing what it was sent out to do, God. And so we put our hope and our trust in this word that brings light and clarity to our lives and to this country. Father, we thank you for your powerful word that's over this nation, God. Let's pray. Perfect, unfailing, steadfast word that we can bank our whole life on it and we will never be disappointed. God, and it's the only way to build my life. It's the only way for a believer to really remain steadfast in our Savior, and it's what we build our churches on, God. And so we thank you, God, for your perfect word. And the word was made flesh, and he came among us, and he fulfilled every word so that I can be counted righteous before God. We thank you for the gospel. We thank you, Lord, for this truth, that not one letter of your word will pass away, but it will remain forever, God. And Jesus has come to fulfill every word in my life, Lord. Thank you for your blessing upon the church in Korea, God. Blessing us with your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We hope that you're reminded of God's goodness and his love, and that he took passage for the rest of this month. We have another watch on Wednesday mornings at 9:30, and again next week